My client was very pleased. I have more work for you, with a more hands-on approach. Your next shot is taped under the phone.
Too bad for you.
My compliments on a job well done, Mr. Thiel. My client was very pleased. I have more work for you, with a more hands-on approach. Your next job is taped under the phone.
Oh my God! Oh my God! Vintage Bel Air. Hey!
Get away from me!
Welcome back and all that stuff. You're on K-Chat with me, Amy Scheckenhausen, on Vice City Station for the stars, including me. And boys, have I got a treat for you. Next up is a living legend, a man who won the World Series single-handed, known to his fans as Death in Tight Pants, and known to his enemies as, oh my God, I just got flattened by a truck. How is that fair? It's sports legend, BJ Smith. So, BJ, welcome.
Thanks. It's a real pleasure to be here.
Oh, I know.
But one thing, sweetheart, I never won the World Series. That's baseball. I played football.
Yes, but it's all the same, isn't it?
Football and baseball aren't the same. In one of them, you get bored during a five-hour game. You touch yourself a lot and start a massive brawl with players who are degenerates, egomaniacs, and criminals. The other's football.
Yes, but it's all the same.
No, it is. Anyone can hit a home run. In baseball, you stand around the field, dividing your salary by 162, waiting for some action. Talk to a guy who just played an hour of football. He's been in the trenches getting Agent Orange sports drink poured all over his head to keep him from taking an innocent life. Imbalance. But that little mustache you busting out looks like you should be talking about some hormone problems, girl.
Excuse me? What did you say?
Oh, damn, baby. You so ugly, you make blind kids cry.
BJ, you better stop being a bully just because I'm not into the jock scene. I like sensitive guys, you know, like actors or rock stars or that kind of thing. Not some great big hulking giant that has to tell everyone how important he is.
Well, I didn't realize we were trying to impress each other here, sweet thing. I was thinking we was here to discuss my new exercise video or talk about my possible comeback in professional football. Not sitting here flirting with each other. I'm a married man. I'm on my set.
So you got a big family. All those wives. That's fantastic.
My big heart has caused me a lot of heartache. In the public eye, you can't always tell what people are about. BJ has met some real manipulative people.
7 wives! That's fantastic!
No, I have one.
Suck the shaft and lick the...
My compliments on a job well done, Mr. Teal. My client was very pleased. I have more work for you, with a more hands-on approach. Your next job is taped under the phone.
Kiss it better.
Running the ball is like making romance. And one day when I was going for a touchdown, if you know what I'm saying, I had a great idea. You see all these fitness videos on television? It's always that idiot fool in leotards prancing about, giving it the skinny thing. And I say, what is this? I mean, what in the world is this? These people ain't fit, they ain't got a clue. When you're fit, you know it. If you come into the locker room, you know I speak.
Oh my God!
For our street, that's what people need. If someone comes to jack your ride, are you gonna bust the aerobic move? Hell no! But when you know how to grab another man by the face mask and twist him around and so he tears ligaments in his back and never play again, I mean, that's some real useful everyday stuff. And I should know.
You know, I just don't want to talk about football anymore.
Well, take a day for washing the car. What good is a leotard when you wash the car? Or put a man in a helmet and a cup, and he can wash the car indignantly. That's fighting fit football. It really bursts some program. The best way to get your body fit is to have total trust in God for your body. Every now and then you wake up and come out of concussion and say, damn. Good.
BJ, you talk funny. We'll be back on K-Chat right after these messages. Are you tired of your couches getting ruined?
Oh, Grandpa.
My leg tinkles again.
If you've got old people cluttering up your room, why not send them to Musty Pond? We'll help bring back...
¡Si te veo otra vez, te rompo la cara!
We'll be right back. Tomas, I appreciate your coming. Forgive me for getting straight to business. Diaz has asked me to oversee a minor business transaction.
Let's hope it goes better than last time.
Which is why I thought of you, my friend. I've dropped some protection at the multi-story car park. Pick it up, then go and watch over Diaz's men at the drop-off. Gracias, amigo.
Diaz, huh? Apparently that angry midget runs this madhouse. Let's see what that creep has to do with things.
Hogging all the action, I see.
Look, you want to do something other than just shadowing me everywhere? Why don't you come along and show me if you're any use?
I might just do that. The name's Lance, by the way.
Tommy Vercetti. Let's go.
Wait, can't you see me down here?
Must be Cortez's new gun.
Until more gainful opportunities arise. They'll be here any minute. We both better get a good vantage point.
Okay, I'll take the balcony, you get the roof across the yard.
Es que no me lo creo, man.
Shit! Diaz's men are getting cut down!
Stupid damn prick!
Don't worry, I got you covered!
You like this shit?
Tommy, I need some help here! Damn!
These Haitians think they could... Don't just stand there, you pricks! Chase the Haitian dickhead down! I live! Take heads, and it's all down to you. What is your name?
Tommy.
I see you soon, amigo, I think.
Shit, where's that guy, Lance?
Diaz. I want to thank you for looking out for me, my man. I asked that prick Cortez, he said you're the real deal, my friend. Will you not come see me? I need a guy like you. All I have now is dickheads. Dickheads everywhere, yo. I make you real rich.